Dear children, how are you all? I hope your work is completed. Okay, today we'll start another topic, which is the last topic of your lesson number one, that is numbers and numeration. A new topic I'm going to start is Roman numerals. Okay, children, you all have been using numbers, digits, since you started studying maths in your nursery class. But have you ever thought of what these numbers are named? Now, there is a name given to these numbers, the digits which you use, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up to 9. So we make use of how many digits to write any numbers? We make use of 10 digits. Okay. Now these 10 digits, you know, these were, who found these? Indians only. Indians developed these digits, but the Arabics, the people who lived in Arab, okay, they spread it to the whole world, that is to other countries. Now these numbers only we are using internationally, not just only in India, but internationally. But since these numbers were developed by Hindus and Arabs, therefore, these numbers are called Hindu-Arabic numerals. Okay, so this is a new term which you are learning now, Hindu-Arabic numerals. Okay, so since ancient times, these numbers were used. Okay, but have you heard of Romans? Yes, the people who lived in Italy, they are called Romans. But Romans, they had a different system of numbers. Okay, they have also been using these numbers since ancient times. Do you know what is ancient? Ancient means since long years. Okay, from last many years. So they had a different system of numbers in which they basically used just 7 symbols. These symbols are I, V, X, L, C, D, M. Okay, so these basic 7 symbols form Roman numerals. Okay, now it's very interesting to see that by using only these 7 symbols, any counting numbers can be written. Okay, that I'll be discussing later on. But there are some rules for it. But children, I think you all must be familiar with some of these symbols. Have you seen where is this I, V, X written? I'm not talking about English alphabets, okay? But to represent some numbers only. Have you ever thought? Okay, I'll take it up later. Okay, but one thing you have to remember, children. Something is missing here. Zero. Okay, you have to remember that Romans had no symbol for zero. Okay, now let me show you what these 7 symbols represent. Okay, now these 7 symbols I'm showing now, these represent Roman symbols. In one table, one column I have written Roman symbols, and in the other one I have written the Hindu-Arabic numerals. Okay, that is also called value of the symbols, so that you know what is the value of these symbols. Now, I represents 1, then V represents 5, X represents 10, L represents 50, C represents 100, and then D is a symbol for representing 500. Okay, so interesting thing is, with the help of these symbols only, we can write all the numbers. Okay, sorry, I've missed one. M is also there. M stands for 1000. Now, to write down the numbers, children, there are some rules. Okay, I'll be giving some examples to discuss the rules. Okay, you just have to go through And later on, tomorrow, I will be sharing the PDF. Not tomorrow, today itself, I'll be sharing the PDF of your book pages. Okay? Now, children, this table which I am showing, you have to note it down in your notebooks. Okay? You will put the heading Roman numerals and then you will write down these seven symbols in your copies. Okay? And some more work again I'll give you later at the end of the session, I'll tell you. Okay? Now, children, I'll be giving an examples to show the rules, and rules you will be then seeing from your book. Okay, you just keep listening. I'll be explaining with the examples. Okay, let me start.